Today date is I think 21st. Now in our last class we concluded with the definition of circular complex convolution integral. Okay, that was something like this one. Okay, I write it again. It is h tilde omega equal to 1 by omega s integration h capital omega w omega minus capital omega d of capital omega minus omega s by 2 to plus omega s by 2. That is our circular complex convolution integral. So this is our circular complex convolution integral. Now we want to investigate the implication of this integral. What do you mean actually by this particular thing? So we start with say W omega. It is what? It is the it is equal to W n e to the power minus j n omega tau, where n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. It has already been defined in our last class. It's defined previously. Okay. But Wn is, it is a one window function, a rectangular window. I want to show you it is something like, again, say this, the last class we found that our Wn is, it extends from minus m minus 1 by 2 to plus m minus 1 by 2. Where its value is 1 and it is 0 for rest of the span of small n. So when we take a summation of Wn from for n varying from minus infinity to plus infinity, effectively we are taking the non-zero values only in the span of plus minus m minus 1 by 2. Okay. So therefore now we can write t is equal to as summation Wn e to the power minus j n omega tau n is varying equal to minus m minus 1 by 2 to plus m minus 1 by 2. Okay. This is our thing. Now we want to find out its the result. Now we take small n, k, some variable k equal to n plus m minus 1 by 2. So when n equal to minus m minus 1 by 2, okay, or k will be equal to 0. And when n equal to plus m minus 1 by 2, our k is what? Is equal to m minus 1. So ultimately our k varies from 0 to m minus 1 here. So our capital W omega equal to summation, we change the variable from n to k. So Wn, okay. So what happened? And one more thing, that in this particular span, our Wn is 1. So it is e to the power minus j n omega tau n varying from minus m minus 1 by 2 to plus m minus 1 by 2. Here, okay, Wn equal to 1 in the range already defined. Okay, so this is that. So what is that? So we put n equal to k minus e to the power minus j n equal to what? K minus m minus 1 by 2. And k is varying from 0 to m minus 1. Okay, now we can take this e to the power plus j m minus 1 by 2. And okay, one more thing, omega tau is here. So omega tau. Okay, this particular thing into summation e to the power minus j k omega tau, k is varying from 0 to m minus 1. Just simple mathematical manipulation. So it is equal to j m minus 1 by 2 omega tau. Now we'll change k to n just. So it is equal to minus j n omega tau. N is varying from 0 to m minus 1. So I write changing the index k to n. Just n is a, k is a local variable within the summation operation. So we can easily change k to any variable here n. Okay. Now we want to evaluate that particular expression, that summation. Okay. Now we know summation of e to the power minus j n omega tau, n is n varying from 0 to m minus 1. It is what? It is a GP series. You know GP series? When we put n equal to 0, it is e to the power 0, 1 plus n equal to 1 means e to the power minus j omega tau plus e to the power minus j 2 omega tau plus e to the power minus j 3 omega tau. So the common ratio is e to the power minus j omega tau. We put n equal to 1 and find the common ratio. And if we put n equal to 0, we get the first term. So n equal to 0 means 1, e to the power 0, 1, which is the first term. And n equal to 1 is the common ratio, which is e to the power minus j omega tau. So it will be, so what is the summation? So first term 1 whole into 1 minus, now common ratio to the power number of terms. Number of terms is what? 0 to m minus 1. So total number of terms is m. So to the power minus j m omega tau. So just the formula, nothing else. Formula of GP series. Minus e to the power 1 minus common ratio. Common ratio is e to the power minus j omega tau. So that is the sum. You already know. Yeah, so that is our this particular thing. So what is our W, capital W of omega? So this sum into this particular expression. Sum into that particular expression. I write it in the next page. I write it in the next page. So page number 2. Okay. So thus we can write W of capital W of omega equal to e to the power, okay, J M minus 1 by 2 omega tau into whole of 1 minus e to the power minus J omega M omega tau. Just I'm writing M earlier to make the consistency, nothing else, that one. Or we can write e to the power j m minus 1 omega tau, sorry, so better I write it, I can write, just write it e to the power j, okay, m omega tau by 2, and this thing we can write it what? E to the power minus j omega tau by 2. So the negative power I write it in the denominator. So j omega tau by 2. So that is the this particular thing into. Get my point? So m omega tau by 2 minus omega tau by 2. So omega tau by 2 is coming in the denominator. So now I multiply the numerator part here with the numerator part of the second term and denominator part of the first term with the denominator part of the second term. So what it will be? It is about j m omega tau by 2 minus, so this minus, so e to the power minus j m omega tau by 2 divided by e to the power j omega tau by 2 minus e to the power minus j omega tau by 2. So this is what? This is 2j e to the power j theta minus e to the power minus j theta. Okay, it is equal to 2j sine. Y, it is e to the power j theta minus e to the power minus j theta. Again, 2j sine. So 2j cancels. Sine m omega tau by 2 divided by sine omega tau by 2. So that is the expression of what? Capital W of omega, which is the frequency response of window function or rectangular window function. This is the frequency response of rectangular window function. Okay, now we want to plot capital W of omega with respect to omega. So how to plot? Let's go to this thing step by step. Step by step, we want to have a method of plotting these. So what we do, we just write net. So plot of W omega, that is our next thing. So we write let theta equal to omega tau by 2. Then what is W, okay, omega or W theta actually? This is now omega tau by 2, so sine m theta by sine theta. Okay. So I write it in the next page. Sine m theta by sine theta. Yeah, I write it in the next page. Page number 3. So W theta equal to, I rewrite this, sine m theta by sine theta can be written as here m into sine m theta by m theta. Okay. Divided by sine theta by theta. So theta cancels and m, capital M is cancelled by that another m, which is introduced. Now let's see what is the plot of sine theta by theta. Sine theta by theta. So its plot will get so it's 0, pi, 2 pi, so this is minus pi, minus 2 pi. So that is the plot of sine theta by theta. So if we replace theta with m theta, so what we'll get? Our sine m theta by m theta, it is just a scaling. Okay, a scaling in the x axis. So it will be compressed. So when theta is multiplied with m, it will be compressed by the factor m. So this is 1 actually here. So it will be so this is 0. That part is pi by m. So it is compressed. When you multiply theta with m, it will be divided by m, you already know. So this will be 2 pi by m. Here also it will be minus pi by m. And that will be minus 2 pi by m. This is a 1. So that is our sine m theta by m theta. So what is our W theta? Our W theta will be just divided by this graph with that one. So it is when the new, it is a numerator divided by the denominator into capital M will be W theta. So we can write, we can plot W theta. So what is that? So just I plot it. Just I am showing some more terms. So this is our M. This is our M. This is pi by M. This is 2 pi by M. It is minus pi by M. It is minus 2 pi by M. Okay, it is that one, theta. W theta versus theta. So note that now we want to convert it to omega. Note that later when theta equal to, say I am identifying this term, when theta equal to pi by m, then what happens? Theta means omega tau by m, omega tau by 2, that is theta equal to pi by m. Then we know it is omega tau means what? Fs, 1 by Fs, so it will be 1 by Fs, pi by m. Fs is the sampling frequency. So omega equal to 2 pi Fs by m, or it is equal to omega s by m. So pi by m, theta equal to pi by m, in the scale of omega, it will be omega s by m, sampling frequency. Angular sampling frequency by m. M is the length of the rectangular window. M is the length of the rectangular window. So what will be the plot of W omega versus omega? So I better I draw it here. So 0, this is m, this is omega s by m, this is 2 omega s by m corresponding to 2 pi by m, it is minus omega s by m, this is minus 2 omega s by m. So it is in the scale of omega, W omega versus omega. So that is our final plot of W omega versus omega. Clear. So next, effectively it is what? It is the convolution of, see in the circular convolution, so it is the convolution of capital H of capital omega with capital W of omega. Okay, it's the circular convolution. Clear. So let's see. After, so what is the implication of that integration? So this will be actually undergoing a convolution with H. So I write it in the next page. Page number 4. When W omega is in convolution with H of capital omega, overshoots and undershoots will occur. In H tilde omega, okay, because of the pulsation of, because of the pulsation of W omega against omega. So what is happening? Consider that this is our H omega versus omega. Okay, so that is this, our H omega frequency response. Now we are convolving it with W omega. So that is this way. Okay. Then after convolution, so after convolution, this is our convolution. When we are convolving them, what will be the result? What will be our H tilde omega? It is, so don't draw it now, just wait a bit. Let me draw first. Okay, so this is our desired frequency response or ideal frequency response of an infinite duration filter. Now our an infinite duration filter cannot be realized in practice. We truncate it up to finite number of terms by using a rectangular window function. So some of the terms are removed. Therefore, okay, we get the pulsation of the frequency response of the truncated rectangular function. So after convolution, our resulting frequency response of the actual filter will be this one. Resulting frequency response of the actual filter is that one. Okay, so I want to show you here that H omega, just see here. H omega is the desired frequency response, okay? Or it is a frequency response of an ideal filter or a brick wall type filter, we call it. What is the thing? And it is the actual filter we are getting. So H omega is what? It is the desired frequency response of an ideal means brick wall type. Why it is called a brick wall type? Brick wall type filter. Now brick wall means just the wall is perfectly vertical. These are as if for a brick made wall made of brick. It is, we know, perfectly vertical. So it is a brick wall type filter or ideal filter. But the ideal filter can be realized only when our HN, the impulse sequence, is of infinite duration. But we cannot implement it in practice, in reality. So we use one window function, rectangular window, that has only finite number of terms. But as soon as we use a finite number of terms of rectangular nature, it pulsates in that way. So effectively, our actual filter from ideal, it changes to this one because of the presence of, okay, this rectangular window. And we know from the properties of Fourier transform that you studied in your last semester class on signals and systems, that our impulse sequence, ideal impulse sequence HN is multiplied with a rectangular window WN. So HN into WN, but that multiplication HN into WN in time domain means it is the convolution in the frequency domain. So HN into WN, so HN into WN is the multiplication here. So we write here is the multiplication in frequency domain. Domain. Okay. So hence, it is the convolution, okay, it is a multiplication in time domain. Time domain is multiplication. So it is a convolution in frequency domain. So that convolution is the circular convolution, because we know that in frequency domain, when is for a discrete time signal, we are getting periodicity in the frequency domain. Since we get periodicity in frequency domain, since we get periodicity in frequency domain, the convolution is a circular one. Is a circular one. So a circular convolution. So convolution with involving periodic signal is a circular convolution, not a linear convolution. You already know. So that is the thing. Okay. But here, note that we are getting a practical filter of that particular nature. But one problem still prevails. What is the problem? That the problem of overshoot and undershoot prevails in the frequency response. Okay. So these overshoots and undershoots, okay, that is ripples. These ripples means up to some time near the edges of the filter, cutoff frequencies are there. So near the cutoff frequencies of the filter, the gain of the filter is somewhat higher than the desired one. Sometimes higher, and outside this cutoff frequency, it is also pulsating a little bit. In some cases, it is higher. Sometimes it is lower than the expected gain, desired gain. Why? Because some pulsation is there present. So these overshoots and undershoots makes the gain higher or lower than the actual gain. Make the gain of the filter somewhat different from the desired gain. So you want to minimize them. These ripples can be minimized. These ripples can be minimized. Okay. How? By replacing the rectangular window, by replacing the rectangular window, rectangular window function, by an appropriate smooth window function. By an appropriate smooth window function, whose amount of side lobes are minimum. Whose amount of side lobes are minimum. Actually, the side lobes are important. Why? Because here you see, okay, the actually the side lobes are, why the just 1 minute, why the side lobes are important? Okay,
The major part, actually the major part of the ripple is mainly due to the last component of the truncated Fourier series. Okay, because when we express our Wn into the Fourier series, okay, then some of the Fourier series are getting truncated. Okay. And then these suddenly truncated series just releases some energy during the span of this particular thing. So that release of energy is manifested in terms of some pulsation. So better I write the reason why we are getting the major part of the ripple in H tilde omega is mainly due to the last component of the truncated Fourier series. What is as obtained in the relation. Okay. So if we use some other type of window function where side lobes are minimum, small, okay, then their removal will not create the pulsation of these, at least appreciably. Clear? So what are the other window functions? Just I can tell you. I'll tell you guys window functions. I go to the next page. Page number. Five. So consider our H omega. Okay, and we use some other window function Wn such that its frequency response W of omega will not have any pulsation. It will be having some nature. Obviously symmetrical. In my drawing, it's not appearing as symmetrical. Then after convolution, okay, it is convolution. Our H tilde omega will be what? This one. So you see, no pulsation is there. Not obviously you are getting some other thing that is not perfectly at the desired level. It is falling little bit. Obviously we can make it more vertical, more the slope can be made higher and higher by choosing a proper window function, but not exactly a brick wall type, but very close to a brick wall type we can make it. So our next study will be, what are the different type of window functions for which we are getting our desired value of H tilde omega? So our next study will be on some window function. There are many window functions. We will not discuss all the thing. Only few, just 4-5 types will be discussed. So next thing is common window functions for FIR filter design. One is the Bartlett window. First type is Bartlett or triangular window. We'll see what is the shape of this thing. Now, first we see our non-causal form. Okay. So it is our Wn equal to 1 minus mod n by m minus 1 by 2. It is for mod n less than equal to m minus 1 by 2 equal to 0 otherwise. It is a non-causal form. So what is the shape of this particular thing? Wn.
So let's see, we are just observing some window functions. Okay, some are, and for every window function, I will show you its non-causal form and causal form. Note that in non-causal form, we are getting a symmetrically located function on either sides of n. The nature is this. Okay, and for causal form, what it will be? Causal window, Wn equal to 2n by m minus 1 for n in lying between 0 and m minus 1 by 2. And is 2 minus 2n by m minus 1 for n in the span of m minus 1 by 2 to m minus 1. This one. And what will be its nature? It is just shifted right by m minus 1 by 2. Zero, it is m minus 1 by 2 and m minus 1, n. This is what? It is a non-causal form, it is a causal form. Non-causal and causal form. Now, what is the difference? In the time domain, it is clearly visible. In frequency domain, what is the difference? Their frequency response? No difference for the magnitude part. Because when we shift it by m minus 1 by 2 to right, it will be one only exponential term will come. So Fourier transform of xt is x omega. Fourier transform of xt minus capital T is e to the power minus j omega tau. Omega at capital T into x original x omega. So a time shift means one exponential term appearing in the frequency domain. So the magnitude of the exponential term is one. So ultimately we get the original frequency response. So whether it is causal or non-causal, HN, its magnitude spectrum is same. I repeat, whether it is causal or non-causal, its magnitude spectrum is shift, is same. The phase spectrum will be what? When it is shifted, some exponential term will introduce some linear phase. It will introduce some linear phase, you already know. E to the power minus j m minus 1 by 2 into omega tau. So a phase shift of omega m minus 1 by 2, okay, into tau will come in the expression. So since it is a linear phase filter, there is no distortion at all. Clear? Start with a non-causal one, we'll shift it to the right side and we'll regarding how to design one FIR filter with window function after completing this chapter, obviously. Okay. Now, our next window function, let's see. So this is our first type of window function. Next, within that small page, I'm not sure whether I'll be able to fit it. So better I go to the next page, page number 6. Next window is Hamming window or raised cosine window. Okay, let's see. So it's non-causal form. Non-causal form is Wn equal to 0.5 plus 0.5 into cos 2 pi n by m minus 1. Okay, for mod n less than equal to m minus 1 by 2 and is 0 otherwise. Okay, and causal form is Wn equal to 0.5 minus 0.5 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1 for n in between 0 and m minus 1 and is 0 otherwise. Okay, let's see its plot. Okay, so it will be something like this. So this is 1. Right, and Wn is in the causal form. So it is the causal form. So it is Hamming window or raised cosine window. This is a gross mistake actually. This is not Hamming window. This is just Han window. Han window, sorry. Really sorry, this is Han window. Okay. Next one is, now I will write the Hamming window. This will be our Hamming window or raised cosine window. its non-causal form. Is Wn equal to 0.54 plus 0.46 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1. This is for mod n in the range of m minus less than equal to m minus 1 by 2 and is 0. Otherwise, and for causal, our Wn equal to 0.54 minus 0.46 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1. It is for mod n in between 0 and m minus 1 and is 0 otherwise. Now, if we plot Wn okay, so this one is that is the nature, non-causal. And causal, this is m minus 1 by 2 and m minus 1. The causal form. Okay. So just we are considering only four type of windows. One is the rectangular window and these other three windows. But okay, one more window I should say give you. I write it in the next page. Total five type of windows, but actual number of windows are much, much more than these. One is Blackman window, its non-causal form is something like Wn equal to 0.42 plus 0.5 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1 plus 0.08 cos 4 pi n by m minus 1 for mod of n less than equal to m minus 1 by 2. Point 42 minus 0.5 cos 2πn by m minus 1 plus 0.08 cos 4πn by m minus 1. It is for mod n, sorry, it is n in between 0 and m minus 1. Okay, and it is 0 otherwise. And what will be the nature? Nature is apparently same. This way non-causal and causal. So this is one here, Wn, so causal form. Yes. Clear? Any doubt? Acha, tomader ki ekhon e ache class ache kichu na ami adh ghonta aro nebo.
Yes, sir, nei.
Acha, thik ache. Tale eta. So next one is, now we want to see how to find out the frequency response in these windows. Just a sample will be given here. Let's see frequency response. Of hand window. It is just a sample only. Following the same procedure, you can find out the frequency response of other windows. Clear? Let's see how. Now for a non-causal hand window, what we can write, Wn equal to, I start with the non-causal because for causal only it will be a time shift. As a result, some exponential term will come. So it's always better to start with non-causal window and then apply time shift property of Fourier transform. for mod n less than equal to m minus 1 by 2 and is 0 otherwise. Yes. Now we first start with our sum w omega equal to, it is what, summation of w n e to the power minus j n omega tau, n is varying from minus m minus 1 by 2 to plus m minus 1 by 2. Okay. So this is equal to WN is 0.5 plus 0.5 cos this one. Just we are replacing the its expression in place of the symbol WM. Clear? Next. Now it is 0.5. Better I can take 0.5 outside. 0.5 e to the power minus j n omega tau plus now it is now cos that particular term. Okay, now so cos theta can be written as e to the power j theta minus e to the power minus j theta by 2. I write it in the next page, page number 8. So it is W omega equal to 0.5 summation because this part is as usual. Now cos. So cos theta e to the power j 2 pi n by m minus 1. So e to the power j 2 pi n by m minus 1. Okay. Plus e to the power minus j 2 pi n by m minus 1 by 2 whole into e to the power minus j n omega tau. It's page number 8 actually. Yes. So now our next thing will be 0.5. Now it is 0.25, 0.5 by 2. 0.25. So e to the power now j. Now we can take e to the power minus jn. It is omega tau minus now this term 2 pi by m minus 1 plus 0.25. Okay, 0.25. So I write it here, see. here also 0.25 into e to the power minus j n omega tau minus, not minus, it will be plus here, plus 2 pi by m minus 1. Yes. Okay. Now what we do, we write, just we want to, these terms are quite similar, quite similar. So we can make a general expression e to the power minus j n theta. N is varying from minus m minus 1 by 2 to plus m minus 1 by 2. This is equal to what? A GP series, actually. So we can take, so let, okay, n plus m minus 1 by 2 equal to k. So when n equal to minus m minus 1 by 2, the lower limit, k will be 0. Okay. So k is 0. And when n equal to plus m minus 1 by 2, k will be m minus 1. And n is replaced by k minus this. So it is e to the power minus j k minus m minus 1 by 2 into theta. So we can take e to the power j, this m minus 1 by 2 into theta outside. And it will be e to the power simply minus j k theta. K is varying from 0 to n minus 1. So this is again a GP series. Okay, so we can write first term. If we put k equal to 0, it is the first term, which is 1. And if we write k equal to 1, it is a common ratio. So it will be 1 minus e to the power minus j common ratio to the power m, because there are m number of terms. So j m theta by 1 minus common ratio. Okay. Or we j m theta by 2 divided by e to the power j theta by 2. We are writing it. We multiply the numerators and denominators separately. E to the power j m theta by 2 minus e to the power minus j m theta by 2 e to the power j theta by 2 minus e to the power minus j theta by 2. So it is 2j sine m theta by 2 divided by 2j sine theta by 2. 2j cancels, obviously. Okay. So from this particular e to the power minus j n theta in here, in place of theta, what we can write? In the first expression, we can write n omega tau. In the second expression, we can write omega tau minus 2 pi by m minus 1. In the third expression, we can write omega tau plus 2m by m plus 1 in place of theta. So we'll write it. So using this relation, we get, I write it in the next page. We get, okay, so I write it in the next page, page number 9. Page number 9. W omega equal to 0.5. Now, in place of theta, it will be just omega tau by 2. Sine omega tau m by 2 divided by sine omega tau by 2 plus. Cooler, I'll cut a piece. Cooler, I'll cut a piece. At a chalta chalmo. अच्छा प्लस 0.25। अरे आचार फुचका एगुलो ना खेले जीवन बिथा कि करो तुम्हरा। अच्छा साइन আমি এই বয়সে আমার কোনো হজমের গন্ডগোল নেই। সাইন ওমেগা টাও ইন প্লেস অফ থিটা ইট উইল বি ওমেগা টাও মাইনাস 2 পাই বাই এম মাইনাস 1 ওকে এন্ড ইনটু এম বাই 2 এন্ড হিয়ার ইন প্লেস অফ থিটা ইট উইল বি সাইন ওমেগা টাও বাই 2 পাই বাই এম মাইনাস 1 ইট ইজ জাস্ট দ্য থিটা into theta by 2 so it will be half I write it half so plus again similarly 0.25 plus 0.25 into sin omega tau plus 2 pi by m minus 1 m by 2 sin omega tau plus 2 pi by m minus 1. Okay. So this is our complete expression, but it's not yet complete. Okay. Now we can write one more thing. What is 2 pi by m minus 1? We can write it. Okay, now 2 pi by m minus 1. It can be written as 2 pi fs, okay, by m minus 1 fs. Now 2 pi fs means omega s and 1 by tau means tau by m minus 1. That looks quite simple. So therefore we can write sin, so we can write it omega tau m by 2 by sin omega tau by 2 plus 0.25. So we can write it just we take here tau outside, so it will be omega minus, so it will be 2 pi by tau or 2 pi fs, so it will be what, just omega s tau, so it will be omega s by m minus 1, sorry, there is a minus sign here, so better I write it 0.25 sin, okay, better I write it 2 pi by m minus 1, we write it omega s tau by m minus 1 m by 2, this expression I am using it here, okay, by sin omega tau minus, okay, omega s tau by m minus 1 half. Clear? Plus the third term 0.25 sin omega tau plus omega s tau by 2 pi by m minus 1 into m by 2 here. The rest part is similar. Only thing is m is equal to not, m is not present. Now we will arrive at our last line. Okay, our last line here. Then we will plot W omega. 0.5. Our first term is sin omega tau m by 2 by sin omega tau by 2 plus 0.25. We take tau common. So sine omega minus omega s by m minus 1 tau m by 2. Here also in the denominator we take omega common. So omega minus omega s by m minus 1 tau by 2. In the third term, sine, it is omega plus omega s by m minus 1 tau m by 2 divided by tau by 2. So this is our final expression W omega. Now the last thing that we'll do today will be just we'll plot W omega versus omega in the next page. Okay. So this is our first term. That is our second term. And this is our third term. First, we'll draw them separately in one figure, then we'll see the superposition of all the three things. Yeah, in the next page, page number 10. So, don't draw anything. I may commit some mistake at this stage while drawing. Okay. This is amplitude. Don't draw anything. Actually, every time I try to draw this thing, I commit some mistake. Oh. সেটুকুলো তাই। আমি খেয়ালও করে নিয়ে আসলে ঠিক আছে চলো। সো দিস ইজ দা অ্যান্ড সো দ্যাট ইজ আওয়ার পিকচার। নাও আওয়ার ওনলি লাস্ট টাস্ক রিমেইনস হিয়ার, উই উইল জাস্ট অ্যাড অল দ্য টার্ম। The three terms are shown separately, but the superposition is quite simple. Okay, it is W omega 0.5 m 0, this is 0 0, so actually you see the main lobe is widened because of the superposition of all the term, and you see the resulting wave, resulting plot, the negative terms are much less because the positive values are more than the negative values in the respective points. That's why in the main lobe actually there is some width of the main lobe of the first term, but here width is much more. Width of the main lobe is much more, okay, and the side lobes are quite smaller. It means that when we truncate the Fourier series of this particular expression, the side lobes are actually not removed, actually they are not contributing to the oscillation of the resulting frequency response. It is not contributing to the oscillation of the resulting frequency response. So your things are quite stable, okay, in the resulting frequency response if we use hand window, and not only hand window, for most of the other windows. Only in rectangular window it is very predominant. And I just forgot to say one more thing in context with rectangular window, that this oscillation at the edges, these are having a particular name. What is that? It is actually called Gibbs phenomenon. Gibbs phenomenon. Okay, so when we get the oscillation near the edges, okay, the gain of the resulting frequency response is somewhat enhanced. Okay, the gain of the resulting frequency response is somewhat enhanced. Clear? So this phenomenon is known, and in this particular case, the peak overshoot is about 9%. The peak overshoot is about 9%. Always it is found. Peak overshoot is around 9%. Okay, this is called Gibbs phenomenon. Obviously, you want to reduce Gibbs phenomenon. How? By choosing proper window function. By choosing proper window function. Okay. Now, I want to conclude today just by mentioning one table. Okay, so this is frequency domain. Characteristic of common window function. Common window function. So I write here type of window. Then it will be approximate width of main lobe. What is that? It is a rectangular window. For rectangular window, what happens? The main width is 2 omega s by m. What is that? I can show you. Just wait, I will show you. Yes, see, for rectangular window, the main lobe, what is the span here? 2 omega s by m. Okay, for rectangular window. What is the approximate width of main lobe? For Bartlett window, it will be 4 omega s by m. For Hamming window, it will be found as again 4 omega s by m. For Hahn window, we have already found it as 4 omega s by m. See here, is what? 2 omega s minus omega s. Approximate is 4 omega s. Just somewhat more than this, but more or less, it is 4 omega s by m. In all the cases, these are just approximate. But for rectangular, it is quite accurate. Exactly 2 omega s by m. And lastly, for Blackman window, it is somewhat more. It's flattened. 6 omega s by m. It is flattened. Okay. That's all about today. Next day, we will start designing of filter. Okay. Designing of FIR filter. A complete design will be shown to you. Okay. From the desired response to the actual. Any question? Let's see. So today I want to stop. Any question? No.